Shalom, my Israelite brothers and sisters. So first of all, I want to give all praises to our Elohim and his holy living son, HaMashiach, or the one we call Yeshua. Boy, do I got some exciting things to share with you today. Man, I can barely contain myself. This is some exciting stuff, y'all. We are literally living in the last seconds of Earth's history. So what I want to talk about today, or what we're going to talk about today, is World War III and the deliverance of Yah's chosen people. Now, of course, no man knows the time, day, or the hour. But brothers and sisters, the signs are ripe, and they've never been riper in any time of Earth's history. We are seeing things happening at an accelerated rate. The Most High is waking up his people all over the world. I'm talking about who knows how many people are waking up daily. Probably tens of thousands. People are just waking up, saints. It is unreal. Never seen a movement like this in my life. This is simply amazing. Let me tell you something, Hebrews. We are the generation that's getting ready to see all this go down. I'm talking about going down harder than Donkey Kong. We never seen nothing like this. Let me share a verse with you right quick. Go to 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. And we'll read verse 2. It says, "For yourselves know perfectly that the day of the Lord so cometh as a thief in the night." Who's going to be a thief for, brothers and sisters? Definitely not us. Not for the chosen people of the Most High. It's going to be for the world. Because think about it. Ever since Trump made this decision to name Jerusalem as the capital, along with some other countries that did the same thing, it's been chaos. It's been crazy. I mean, it's been chaos before, but it's even worse. It's all over the place. And this stuff they're trying to hide in the news. But I'm going to show you some clips. I'm going to show you, y'all, what they're not telling us, or what they're not showing us in the news. Because the same wicked people who own all the news medias and outlets and everything, you know, they monitor and they control what goes onto those medias, like CNN, Fox News, all your news stations. So it's going to be a thief. It's going to be a thief for the heathens, because the heathens, they look over to Jerusalem as those Khazars as the real Jews. The whole world is fooled, y'all. It's going to be a terrible, terrible wake-up call. Now I know why it says that there will be gnashing of teeth and great wailing. Now, speaking about the Khazars, let me show y'all something before I forget, while it's on my mind. There's a book I want to share with you. It's called The 13th Tribe by Arthur Kessler. Now, I encourage all you get this book, but I want to read something to you. Let me check it out right quick. Let me read this to you. It says, "Arab historians traces the origins of the Khazars back to Japheth, the third son of Noah." This man was killed over this book, brothers and sisters. The guy who wrote this book, Arthur Kessler, was killed over this book. They know that those people over there are not Jews. They know that. The whole world knows that. The world leaders know it, but yet they want to hide it from us. They spent trillions of dollars in media just to keep us ignorant. Everything, music industries, religion especially. And now that Israel is waking up, now that the Israelites all over the world are waking up, the world leaders are going into panic mode. They don't know what to do with themselves. These world leaders are trying to deflect the best way they can to take all the attention off the rising Israelites. They're trying to do it, y'all. They know. Don't think that they don't watch our videos. They're watching the videos. They're probably watching all the videos that Israelites are putting out. People are waking up. They're watching this stuff. They are watching us, brothers and sisters. No doubt. And they're panicking. They're getting scared because they know the prophecies of the Most High. They know that once we wake up and realize who we are and we get back to keeping Torah, it's a done deal. It's going to be a wrap for them, and they know it. All right, let's get another script. Now, we know that the script says that our land is going to be trodden down underfoot by the Gentiles. So let's go to Luke 21 and verse 24. And it says, "And they shall fall by the edge of the sword, and shall be led away captive into all nations, and Jerusalem shall be trodden down of the Gentiles, until the times of the Gentiles be fulfilled." That's amazing, y'all. We're seeing that now. We're seeing that with all the symbolic plagues of Egypt falling. Now, I'm going to tell you something. Y'all think the California fires are bad? Y'all think the hurricanes were bad? Y'all think the tornadoes were bad? We ain't seen nothing yet. And this year alone was the worst. Just imagine what next year is going to be like. Just imagine what next year is going to bring and what kind of destructions it's going to bring. The time of the heathen is here. And we're seeing it. We're seeing it on a large scale. And it's happening so much and it's so widespread that they can't even hide it in the news like they want to. It's coming out. Now I want to show you a clip. And in this clip is about a man named Albert Pike. Now I showed the full version of this clip in one of my videos entitled "The Prophecies of Zechariah 12:3 is Coming to Pass." But I just want to show you a particular clip in this video, because World War III was predicted by the Illuminati since the 1800s. Well, you may say, well, how is that possible? How come the Most High just don't stop it? Well, I'm going to tell you something. Remember what it says in the scripts in Job 9:24. It says the world is given into the hands of the wicked. So the Most High is going to allow them to go so far. And I'm going to prove it. I'm going to prove it to you with a verse in the script after this clip. He's going to allow them to get up their weapons, develop whatever they want to develop. The Most High ain't going to be playing, y'all. This is getting ready to get exciting. But anyway, in this clip, I want you to pay attention, because the whole idea of the Third World War is to bring up the Zionist Jewish folks, the Zionist Khazars, against the Islamic world. They want to cause them to come together and destroy one another. And that's what's getting ready to happen. Even the Bible predicted that. It talked about numerous times that the war is going to start in the east, around the Mediterranean. Boy, this is getting ready to heat up, y'all. It's already heating up. So check out this little clip I'm going to show you, and then we're going to come back and discuss some more and get some more scripts.
Satan, Prince of the World. He documents that World War III was planned by a 33rd degree grand wizard named Albert Pike. Albert Pike was a notorious Luciferian who openly praised Lucifer in his book, Moral and Dogma of the Ancient and Accepted Scottish Rite of Freemasonry. Pike was also a general for the Confederacy during the Civil War, and a wizard of occult magic, channeling and summoning of spirits. William Carr documented that Albert Pike wrote a letter to a friend in 1871, outlining the final and largest of the wars. According to Carr, what Albert Pike actually wrote was a lot more than a letter. It was a blueprint that spelled out exactly what would happen in the last war. Carr said, quote, "In the 1860s, Albert Pike is recorded as saying his military program might take 100 years or a little longer to reach the day when those who direct the conspiracy at the top will crown their leader king despot of the entire world and impose a Luciferian totalitarian dictatorship upon what is left of the human race." That's what they're saying. Pike seems to indicate a conspiracy to start a war so that the Antichrist can ascend to his position as world ruler. Pike's letter ironically also detailed the specifics of the first two wars with stunning accuracy, suggesting that he knew before time the details surrounding each of the wars. World War I, according to Pike, would be fought to overthrow the czars in Russia and change Russia into a communist state. The Second World War would be fought for two reasons: to establish the State of Israel and to expand communist control over Europe. The Third World War will be what allows the Novus Ordo Seclorum to rise out of the dust. According to Pike, Islam will be the central factor in the downfall of the West. Islam will be decimated in the process, allowing for the new religion of pure Luciferianism to spread on the earth. All Muslims will fall for this system. There isn't a single Muslim on earth who will not partake in the religion of the New World Order, according to Pike. Islam is merely a tool to destroy the Christian West. That's it. That's all it is. It's a tool. That's what they said hundreds of years ago.
So this devil named Albert Pike, along with the rest of his Luciferian buddies, conjured up a plan during the 1800s, hundreds of years ago, for all three wars. All three wars. Y'all hear me, saints? These people are on a mission. These Luciferians, they are on a mission to try to destroy the Most High and the chosen people of the Most High. That's their mission. That is their goal. That's what they want to accomplish. Why do you think they kept our identity hid from us for all this time? They know this stuff. And the Most High is allowing them to go so far. And the Most High is going to show these devils who they're messing with. Oh, we ain't seen nothing yet. We ain't seen nothing yet. Now, this decision of Trump announcing Jerusalem as the capital couldn't have come at a better time, because what Trump did, and I call him Agent Orange. So what Agent Orange did, he was just following the instructions of his Luciferian slave masters. That's it. That's what he was doing. It was time. The time was ripe, and it was time to make that announcement. Now, let me show you what the news media did not put on your big networks like CNN, Fox. This is stuff you have to dig for. You got to dig for this stuff. After Trump made the decision to announce Jerusalem, there was all kind of rage. And I never saw this video before, and I was looking for something like this. So finally, I found it. And I'm like, wow, this is crazy. But they don't want to show us. They don't want the media to show us. It's out there. You just have to really search for it. So here it is. This is crazy, saints. Unbelievable. And we're seeing this prophecy fulfilled right before our very eyes. Now, this was recorded on December 8th. Just imagine, it's December 27th right now. Just imagine what it's like across the globe. It's chaos, brothers and sisters. It's off the chain. And it's going to get worse. Well, I'm going to say it's going to get better for us, because we know that the time of the Gentiles is here. So this whole thing was planned out by these Luciferians hundreds of years ago, that that's what they wanted to do for this last war, was to get the Islamic against the Zionists. That's going to be some amazing stuff. And I know, and I've been saying this for a long time, I truly believe Iran's going to mess around and nuke Israel. I could be wrong. But the tensions are high, And we're going to talk about this military lineup here pretty soon, but tensions are high, brothers and sisters. The logistics of World War III has already started already. Armies are lining up their forces everywhere. Man, boy, we're living in some exciting times. Let's talk about these wars and rumors of wars. Wars has been going on ever since 200 years since Yeshua was on the scene. You had your Arabia Wars, which was the neighboring countries of the Roman Empire who were warring against them, and that was part of the breakup of the Roman Empire. You had your French Revolution, you had your British War, you had your Civil War with America, you had the Alamo War with the Mexicans, you had World War I, World War II, the Korean War, the Vietnam War, Desert Storm, Iraq 2013. All these wars and rumors of war have been going on for a very long time, brothers and sisters. So let's go to Matthew 24 and verse 6. I'm going to read verse 6 and 7. And it says, "Ye shall hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that ye be not troubled, for all these things must come to pass. But the end is not yet. For nation shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. And there shall be famines and pestilence and earthquakes in diverse places." Are we not seeing these things? And these things have been going on for a while, brothers and sisters. We're way past this point. But let's get something else. Let's go to 2nd Esdras, because I want to show you something similar. All right, let's go to 2nd Esdras chapter 13, and we're going to read verses 29 through 31. And it says, "Behold, the days come when the Most High will begin to deliver them that are upon the earth," meaning his chosen people, "and he shall come to the astonishment of them that dwell on the earth." Verse 31, "And one shall undertake to fight against another, one city against another, one place against another, one people against another, and one realm against another." Now, did we not just read this in Matthew 24? Nation shall rise against nation. It's getting ready to go down, brothers and sisters. Do we not see the nations warring against one another right now in all kind of logistical battles? Let me give you an example. Take the petrodollar. How many of y'all know what the petrodollar is? So for those of you who don't know what the petrodollar is, it's what America trades in oil. It's like American dollars, but back in 1971, it was an agreement that any country trading in oil must trade in petrodollars. Well, that was only because of greed and control of the U.S. But now that these other countries have gained in financial, you know, like Russia, China, all these other countries, Venezuela, they're starting to trade over to the, instead of using the petrodollar, they're trading over to the yuan, the Chinese yuan. And the Chinese yuan is in charge of that. Now Russia's trading over to the Chinese yuan to trade in oil. North Korea, Venezuela. Why do you think the U.S. wants to go to war with all these countries? Why this whole thing to announce Jerusalem the capital? There's a reason for that. They want to go to war with these countries so they can try to remain control. But the petrodollar is failing. It is, and it's probably already done. So these people are desperate. These world leaders are super desperate what they're trying to do. Y'all remember Saddam Hussein, the leader of Iraq? That's right. Remember when he started trading oil in euros? Oh, the U.S. didn't like that. That was a no-no. You see what happened? U.S. went in, killed the man, killed his sons, took over the country. It was never, ever about trying to rebuild Iraq. It was never about that. That place is still war torn. It was always about the oil, the control. Same thing with Muammar Gaddafi. You know, they got him to get rid of his nuclear weapons, and they destroyed him because he, along with some other African leaders, were trying to come up with an African currency. And that would have put the petrodollar out of business. So they couldn't have that. But see, now they can't stop China. They can't stop Russia because they're both trading in the yuan now instead of the petrodollar. So this, it's getting serious, y'all. This is stuff that nobody's talking about. And I haven't heard too many Hebrews talking about this, but this stuff is going on. This is prophecy, brothers and sisters, fulfilling right before our very eyes. We're getting ready to look at a the biggest economic collapse, and they're doing this to bring on the war. That's the whole purpose. But guess what? Here's the good news. The Most High is still the one who's pulling all the strings, because he's allowing these devils to do their thing. This is why we need to get right, brothers and sisters, with the Most High. We don't have time to be playing around, be playing games. We need to be in this word studying, trying to keep these laws and commandments and statutes the best way we can to get out of here so we can get the kingdom. A lot of us are going to be persecuted. A lot of us are going to be killed for our faith. We got to be strong, brothers and sisters. That's why we have to study, so we can train our mind mentally to be ready for these last days. Let me share with you what the Most High is getting ready to do with these devils. Boy, I'm telling y'all, these heathens, boy, these world leaders, they really think that they're going to be able to destroy our Elohim. They have no idea of the power of the Most High. Boy, they're in for a treat, aren't they? Let's go to 2 Ezra chapter 15. I'm going to read verses 20 through 21. And it says, "Behold, saith Elohim, I will call together all the kings of the earth to reverence me." So the Most High is like, he's going to tell these leaders, go get your generals, go get your weapons, all your equipment, your most advanced things that you can use. Go ahead and get your Project Blue Beam so you can try to trick the masses. Go ahead and mess with your CERN that you've been trying to open up portals and all that kind of stuff. Get your generals, your sergeants, get all your chief captains, get them ready. Get them ready. Watch this. It says, "Which are from the rising of the sun, from the south, from the east, and Lebanon." Here we go. Watch what the Most High is getting ready to do. "To turn themselves one against another and repay the things that they have done to them." Who was them? Let's look at the next verse. Verse 21. It says, "Like as they do yet this day," meaning this current day, 2017, "unto this day, unto my chosen. He is, the Most High is specifically referring to his chosen people. That would be us, Israel, the so-called blacks scattered to the four corners of the earth, or as you want to say, Negroes. Let me read that verse again, because it sounded real good. Verse 21, "Like as they do yet this day unto my chosen, so will I do also, and recompense in their bosom. Thus said the Lord Elohim." Boy, we're getting ready to see some stuff happen. Now, we're already seeing things happen, but this ain't nothing. We're talking about billions getting ready to die. And this whole build up to World War III. See, that's the end game. World War III is the end game. Once World War III starts, brothers and sisters, the real war, it's a wrap. It's a wrap. There's no turning back. Because y'all imagine the nuclear weapons they got now? Now, the two bombs they dropped on Hiroshima and Nagasaki, that wasn't nothing. Those are like little firecrackers compared to what we got now. That was like over 70 years later. Look how advanced we've gotten. They got this bomb, this nuclear bomb that Russia has. It's called the Satan. That thing can destroy the whole state of Texas in one setting. We're living in a time and some powerful weapons, brothers and sisters. And I want to show y'all something with this blue beam, because that's another thing. These folks are getting ready to try to deceive the masses with this blue beam. They know we're waking up. They know that we know who we are as a people, and the gig is up on this white Jesus, because it's done. It's a wrap. But they're going to try to use this Project Blue Beam to try to imitate this rapture. They're going to make this white Jesus appear out of the sky, people, so people can believe. I'm going to show you a little clip on it so y'all can see what this blue beam can do. It's crazy, y'all. They got some crazy stuff out here. Check out this clip. That was crazy, wasn't it, Saints? I'm telling y'all, they got some technology out there that'll blow your mind away. And this is actually old technology. This Project Bluebeam has been around since the 70s. They've been working on this stuff for a while. You really think that these the world leaders, the powers that be, you think that they're gonna just tell the public publicly, hey, we got this new technology out now? No, they're gonna keep it to themselves because they wanna reveal it to the masses because they know the masses will be deceived. Now you have some people who know about this stuff, but for the most part, people are gonna be deceived. And these people have been looking for a white Jesus to come out the sky all this time, and they're about to get it. And they're gonna be amazed, but it's not gonna be the real one. So these people, they got some stuff out there, brothers and sisters. So these doubles, the powers that be, they're getting ready to try to deceive the masses. But don't be fooled, saints. Let's go to 2 Thessalonians chapter 2 and verse 9. Let me show you what it says. It says, even him whose coming is after the working of Satan with all power and signs and lying wonders. This is what they're doing, brothers and sisters. And they've been doing it ever since, like they've been really increasing it since 2015. Different parts of the world, they've been displaying this kind of stuff, making people think they're seeing UFOs and all this kind of stuff. They've been playing with their toys for a while now, all over the place. You know, so, and also, the Most High told us not to learn the way of the heathens, nor be dismayed by the signs of heaven in Jeremiah 10:2. Why? Because the Most High is not sending us signs through the heavens. The Most High has already given us everything through his word, brothers and sisters. So Hebrews, if you're the type of person that you're into all these signs in the heavens, don't do it, because that's not the way of the Most High. The Most High gave us his word. That's where you need to be at, is in the word, not worrying about what's going on in these skies, because that's all coming from Satan. That's the lying wonders of these devils, what they're trying to do to trick people. And they're going to fool a lot of people. And all this they want to do, and this is all leading up to the war. It's all leading up to World War III. And brothers and sisters, I can't stress enough. Literally, we are living in the last seconds. I don't even think we realize how close we are to this thing that's getting ready to fall. This place, all these world leaders, everything, all of it, it's coming to an end. And it's all because of us. Hallelujah. Let me just give you a visual how close we are to the Most High's return. Now, y'all all remember Daniel 2, the image, talking about the four great world empires. You had Babylon, you had Medo-Persia, Greece, and Rome. And then the feet were of miry clay, partly clay and iron. Now, that's the European Union. Now, if y'all haven't noticed, did y'all notice some time back ago, the British, they pulled out of the Brits. Now, that's a big deal. They made a big deal about that, too. So that's part of the not coming together, the clay and the iron, because the European Union, they're fighting amongst one another right now. They can't seem to come together. But this was prophesied in Daniel chapter 2, and we're seeing that now. And especially with the other countries starting to trade with the yuan, the Chinese yuan, from the petrodollar, that's causing a lot of heat right now. So the pressure's on. But see, this is the thing, brothers and sisters. They're not going to come out and tell you publicly that the American dollar is struggling. They're not going to do that because they want to fool the masses. They don't care about that. They want to make sure that they secure their own needs. These elites, Illuminatis, the powers that be. So the Most High is getting ready to break them. Now I want to tell y'all something. Have y'all noticed a heavily increase and military exercises all over the world? It's been increasing. Now you can look at news articles, you can pull it up. It's out there, brothers and sisters. I'm talking about, I've never seen an increase of military exercise like this. This is why I'm saying that the World War III has already started logistically. They're lining up their forces all over Russia, putting their forces, and they're labeling them as drills. That's what they're calling them. They're calling them drills. But they're practicing real-time war scenarios. as though if something could break off at any moment, they'll be ready. They'll have their equipment, they'll have their weapons, all their ammunition, everything that they need. But so I'm telling you, this thing is hitting heavy. So this is a lineup I created for y'all to see, give you a visual. So the allies, right now, you have USA, you have Israel, you have South Korea, Japan, and Canada, and a few other smaller ones. And then on the right, you have Russia, China, North Korea, Iran, and Syria. So those are your main heavy hitter allies. Now, everybody else in between, you know, they can join either side at any time. That's what I'm saying. When the Most High says that nation shall turn against nation, a lot of these people are going to jump ship, and they don't know, they're not going to know who to fight, because they're going to be trying to fight one another, and it's going to be chaos, y'all. But this is the allied lineup right here. This is what they're going for. And now, you know, the whole rhetoric between Trump and North Korea, all that stuff has been going on constantly. But their military buildup has been there, and it's increased over the months. I mean, it's crazy, but nobody's paying attention to it. No one's seeing it. So I'm sharing this with you, brothers and sisters, because I want you to see the significance of this thing. We are close. We can literally go to sleep tonight and wake up tomorrow, we'd be in World War III. It's that sudden, you know? I'm not saying it's going to pop off like that, but we just never know. You know, we're living in a time where it's so unpredictable right now. It's not even funny. This third war is going to be so severe that once it starts, ain't no stopping it. Now, you know the Most High is going to deliver his people in that hour. The Most High is not going to allow his people to be destroyed by this war. Now, if you read the last two books of 2 Ezra, chapter 15 and 16, it talks about this war. But I want to bring attention to a particular script that describes the horror that's going to be on this earth, brothers and sisters, when this war hits for the heathen. Let's go to 2 Ezra, chapter 16. And I want to read verse 22. Through 31. This is a mouthful. This is some heavy stuff. It says, "For many of them that dwell upon the earth shall perish of famine, and of other that escape the hunger shall the sword destroy." Wow, that's going to be serious. Verse 23, "And the dead shall be cast out as dung, and there shall be no man to comfort them, for the earth shall be wasted, and the city shall be cast down. There shall be no man left to till the earth and to sow it. The trees shall give fruit, and who shall gather them? The grapes shall ripen, and who shall tread them? For all places shall be desolate of men, so that one man shall desire to see another and to hear his voice. For of the city there shall be 10 left, and 2 of the field, which shall hide themselves in the thick groves and in the clefts of the rock. As an altar of olives upon every tree, there are left 3 or 4 olives. Or as when a vineyard is gathered, there are left some clusters of them that diligently seek through the vineyard. Even so in those days shall there be 3 or 4 left by them that search their houses with the sword." This is crazy, y'all. So this is describing what it's going to be like when this war hits. Y'all remember this movie called The Book of Eli? Yeah, Denzel Washington played in. It's going to be like that. He was a walker going around. You know, there was a few people in the cities. And man, it's crazy. And these people, they're going to be so few. They're going to be wandering around because all the wicked are going to be dead. All the heathen are going to be destroyed. But the Most High's people, we're going to be delivered. We're going to be delivered. Man, this is like a scene out of the Book of Eli. Straight up, when you read this, that's what it reminds you of. I mean, it's like to the T. Maybe when they made the Book of Eli, maybe they took these scriptures and they made it just like it said in Ezra. But that is something. These heathens are going to be in such a disarray. they're not going to know what to do, you know, for the ones who survived. But for the Most High's people, we're going to be delivered, brothers and sisters. Boy, this is a good thing. And this is some exciting times. The only people that's really paying attention to the signs that are going on that's leading up to this war is Yah's chosen people. We're seeing it, y'all. We are seeing it. Just like it says in Ezra, and this war coming, it's going to be a cloud, one cloud after another, one cloud after another. All that smoke, those nuclear bombs going off everywhere. Because you know when one country sends off a nuclear bomb, you know somebody else is sending off a nuclear bomb. Ain't no one country just going to send off a nuclear bomb and it's going to be it. Just about every country, major country, got nuclear weapons. It's about to get set off, y'all. Like real fire set off. Brothers and sisters, the Most High is getting ready to turn the captivity of his people. And he's pretty much already turned the captivity of his people. Now, granted, there are some curses that we're going to have to live out until Yeshua returns. But, wow, it is happening so fast. Let me read something to you. Go to Deuteronomy chapter 30. Deuteronomy chapter 30, and I'm going to read verses 1 through 3. And it says, "And it shall come to pass, when all these things are come upon thee, the blessing and curse which I have set before thee, and thou shalt call them to mind among all nations, whether the Lord thy Elohim hath driven thee, and shalt return unto the Lord thy Elohim, and shalt obey his voice according to all that I commanded thee this day, thou and thy children, with all thine heart and with all thy soul." Here we go. Listen to this one. "That then the Lord thy Elohim will turn the captivity and have compassion upon thee, and will return and gather thee from all the nations, whether the Lord thy Elohim hath scattered thee." Brothers and sisters, it's almost done. And as we're waking up as a people, and who knows, you know, the chosen people of the Most High could be already sealed already. The Most High could already have the numbers. What do we know? We don't know how many people are waking up on a daily basis. We're just flesh and blood. But we're waking up. You know, I don't know how much time we got left on this planet. Nobody else does. But we know that things are happening fast. We know that it's getting close. And people are waking up by the thousands. That's all I know. And so the quicker we get back to Torah, brothers and sisters, the quicker the Lord will come and get his people. But that's an important thing. We must see, it's not enough just to wake up and acknowledge that we're Israel. We can't just wake up and say, "Hey, I'm a Hebrew Israelite," and then we still eating pork and shrimp and embracing the pagan holidays and what have you, and calling ourselves Hebrew Israelite. You cannot serve two masters. So it's all about change of lifestyle. That's what's going to get us home, brothers and sisters. That's what's going to get us out of here. So that's what we got to do. All right, brothers and sisters, turn with me to Psalms 91, one of my many favorites. And let's look at verse 1. It says, "He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty." Is that not what we commanded to do, brothers and sisters? We must abide in Yeshua. We must abide in him. Verse 2, "I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my Elohim, in him will I trust." We need to trust in the Most High, brothers and sisters. It is the only way. "Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence." Have we not been seeing all these symbolic plagues of Egypt falling all over the place? The opioids and the fires and the hurricanes, the floods, the famine. But the Most High has been protecting his people. He has been protecting his people. "He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler." What is a shield and buckler, brothers and sisters? It's his law. Check out Deuteronomy 6:25. it says, it shall be our righteousness if we do to observe these commandments that the Most High has given us. This is why these laws, commandments, and statutes are very important, brothers and sisters. We gotta keep the Torah. We can't just say we're Israelites. We can't just say we're Hebrew Israelites. Verse 5, thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day. We're seeing a lot of stuff happening right now, but the Most High is going to protect his people. Now get this one. I love this one. This is getting really good. It says, verse 6, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasted at noonday. You know, everywhere we go, there's something happening. You know, we're even when we get in our cars and we drive somewhere, you know, there's no guarantee. But the Most High protects us. And here's the one I really want to get to, verse 7. And it says, let me highlight it right quick, because this is a really good one. It says, 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. Y'all hear that, saints? Do we not see the things that are happening to these heathens? And it's gonna get even better. Remember, we just read in 2 Ezra 16 that it's gonna be like 10, 2, 3 left to a city. The population of this earth is about 7 billion right now. It's probably a little more than that. I'm telling y'all, brothers and sisters, billions of people are getting ready to die, just like it was in the flood, when only 8 were saved. Billions of people are getting ready to die. And this crazy Christian sanity stuff that people are just, God is love. Oh, you shouldn't talk about that. You know, sometimes I just want to bust them upside the head with some watermelons. I don't understand our people sometimes. Verse 8, read this last one. It says, only with thine eyes shalt thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. Brothers and sisters, we are living in a time where we're going to see the reward of our wicked. And this is something that our forefathers could have wished they would have saw. Can you imagine the apostles? They're in their graves right now, but can you imagine that they wanted to see this moment that we're going to be seeing? This is some heavy stuff, brothers and sisters. This is something to really rejoice about. Wow. So, we got to put our hands to the plows. We got to get to these laws. Make haste to keep these laws. We are literally the generation that is going to witness total annihilation of our enemies. That's some powerful stuff. And it just gives me goosebumps just even thinking about it. And this is why I always pray every day, you know, like Paul, we have to die daily. We have to die daily, constantly. Pray for one another, our brothers and sisters scattered to the four corners of the earth. Everything's in alignment. This whole war, the logistics, the lining of all the forces, the U.S. forces, the Russian forces, the Chinese forces, the North Korean forces, the South Korean forces, it's there, brothers and sisters, right before our eyes. But the heathen don't even know what's happening. This is why it's going to hit them like a whirlwind. They have no idea what's coming to them. That is why the Holy HaMashiach said, my coming is going to be like a thief in the night. It's going to be so sudden, but it's not going to be a thief in the night for Yah's chosen people. Go to me with Micah chapter 5. And let's read chapter 15. Micah 5:15. And it says, and I will execute vengeance in anger and fury upon the heathen, such as they have not heard. Y'all hear that, saints? Such as they have not heard. So in other words, there's never been a time on this earth history that this judgment has come upon the heathen. It's going to be so severe. It's going to be worse than anything that the world has ever seen. We thought the flood, I mean, we wouldn't alive when the flood happened, but you know, we read about it, we know that was bad. But can you imagine something 100 times worse than the flood? That's sick, y'all. That is sick. And we're living in a time of the heathens. where we're seeing all this stuff's getting ready to fall, no wonder they're starting to panic. And no wonder where it says in Isaiah 14 that they're going to cling to Israel, but we're going to take them as handmaids and servants. Wow, y'all, this is something. This is something. The good news is the Most High is going to gather his elect from the four corners of the earth. Unfortunately, brothers and sisters, you know that a lot of our people are not going to make it. And I hate that. You know, I really do. I hate to even imagine in that. But the scriptures don't lie. And it is what it is. But for those of us who are awakened, we got to make sure we keep our hand to this plow and keep afflicting our souls. Go with me to Isaiah 11, Isaiah chapter 11 and verse 11. Let's hear the good news of what the Most High is getting ready to do for his people. And it says, "And it shall come to pass in that day that the Lord shall set his hand again the second time to recover the remnant of his people, which shall be left from Assyria and from Egypt and from Pathros and from Cush and from Elam and from Shinar and from Hamath and from the islands of the sea." Now, we know that this is talking about specifically the northern tribes, which were left from Assyrian, which is still today, is spread out through some parts of Africa, the Mediterranean, the Middle East, all the little countries over there. So we have our people everywhere, brothers and sisters, everywhere. So this is going to be one pleasant sight to see. This is going to be something. All right, go ahead and turn to Mark chapter 13. And verse 27. Let's deal with the rest of the Most High's elect. Mark 13 and verse 27. And it says, "And then shall he send his angels, and he shall gather together his elect from the four winds, from the uttermost part of the earth to the uttermost part of the heaven." There you have it, brothers and sisters. Our people are going to be gathered. The Most High's people are going to be gathered from the four corners of the earth. And this is going to happen right when this war starts kicking off. Because I'm telling you, once the bombs start falling, that's it. That's a wrap. There's no way you can recover from nuclear bombs. You might as well call it a day. And these heathens that are going to be trying to hide in the rocks and the clefts and under the sea, what have you, they're not going to be able to escape the judgment of the Most High. They're going to be getting bit by some leviathans, get swallowed up whole, trying to hide away on their underground ships and their underground bunkers and what have you. So we're seeing some things, brothers and sisters. We're seeing everything right before our eyes being fulfilled. Everything we've been through as Yah's chosen people, all the discrimination against us, the hatred, the torture, the persecution, the killings, it's going to all be worth it, saints. Go to 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 and verse 16 and 17. It says, "For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the shofar, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of Elohim, and the dead and Yeshua shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord." Brothers and sisters, this is going to be a scene that's going to be so surreal. It's going to feel like it's unreal. It's going to feel like a dream, because we've never experienced nothing like that. Matter of fact, we've never experienced freedom. We don't even know what it's like to be in freedom. We've been in bondage all our lives since birth. You know, this is going to be such an event like never before. Now, Yeshua's coming is going to come to a shock to every single heathen on the face of this earth. Let me tell you why. Go to Wisdom of Solomon in the Apocrypha. The Wisdom of Solomon chapter 5. I'm going to read verses 1 through 2. It says, "Then shall the righteous man stand in great boldness before the face of such as have afflicted him and made no account of his labors. When they see it, they shall be troubled with terrible fear and shall be amazed at the strangeness, y'all hear that? At the strangeness of his salvation. Talking about the Most High. So far beyond all that they looked for. What are they looking for? They're looking for a white Jesus to come out of the sky. Verse 3. And they, repenting and groaning for anguish of spirit, shall say within themselves, this was he? This was this nigga that's coming out? What? A black man? Whom we had sometimes in derision and a proverb of reproach. They're not going to believe their eyes, brothers and sisters. The heathens are going to be scared out of their minds. That's why it says that they're going to call upon the rocks and the mountains to fall upon them. Hide us from the face of him that sitteth on the throne. They're going to be scared out of their minds. They don't know what's going on. Wait a minute. This black man is coming back for these niggas? No way. They're going to think it's an alien invasion. And that's why when this war is going on, brothers and sisters, they're going to be fighting each other. And guess what's going to happen? They're going to be fighting each other. And all of a sudden, Yeshua is going to come out of the sky with his angelic hosts. And the whole armies of the earth are going to turn their weapons from shooting themselves against one another. They're going to point them towards the Most High. And that's when all hell is going to break loose. And that's when you're going to see total annihilation of the wicked. It's going to be a sight to see, saints. Brothers and sisters, as the chosen children of the Most High, and as we're seeing all these plagues fall left and right, and we're seeing prophecy unfold right before our very eyes, what is the number one thing that is required of us? Well, I'm going to show you from scriptures. Go to Revelation chapter 14 and verse 12. And it's simple. It says, here is the patience of the saint. Here are they that keep the commandments of Elohim and the faith of Yeshua. That's it, brothers and sisters. It all boils down to these laws, commandments, and statutes. That's what it boils down to. This is why we're still here today, because we, our forefathers, broke Elohim's laws. We would never be in this condition if that would have not happened. We would have been ruling the world right now. We wouldn't be going through all this torture and all this pain and agony and all the stuff that we're going through right now. So, brothers and sisters, I just want to give you some encouragement and let you know that, hey, this thing is on the rise. We are rising as a people, and as we're rising as a people, the plagues are starting to fall, and the heathen are starting to panic. They're getting scared. And it's going to get worse and worse, because once they catch the true wind of who we are, oh, it's game on. They're coming after us. So be prepared, saints. Get ready. Study hard. Stay in Yeshua. Search his righteousness. We have to do it every day. We have to work out our own salvation with fear and trembling. So, brothers and sisters, I just want to say it's an honor to be able to serve you all, my Israelite brothers and sisters scattered to the four corners of the earth. Stay encouraged. Keep your head up, stay in the word, and I say shalom.